Welcome back to the channel. Now I've been out picking up from a lorry the next supposed to be family car. Garage is filled up here. It's another Toyota Land Cruiser. This time it's a VX. I have cloth instead of leather inside. 5-seater. I can't open it just now because I put in this situation with all the viruses and things. I just put in an ozone machine to just kill off smell and bacteria and viruses and things in the car. See if that do something. When I picked it up, it smelled a little of smoke, but now that smell have gone away. I think that could have been just from car standing. I hope so. This car is 2006 model. Have the same engine as the other Land Cruiser we have. 3 liters D4D Toyota diesel engine. I have to try to see if I find some information about the timing belt. If I don't find anything, I'm just going to open it and see. So, I'm going to find out more about that. Can't see anything right away. When I was servicing the other car, the GX 2004, then I changed the timing belt, I changed the air filter, I cleaned the muff sensor. It was dirty. And go over things, the same I have to do here. Air filter, inside and QP filter, everything I just have to go over. Also, this one I'm going to put back plates on. Everything is supposed to be. I'm just looking for if I get some kind of information about timing belt change. But it's nothing. No information when it's done. So I just have to find out more about that. But the first thing I can start with, like on all the other used cars, oil up the screws. Spaces I see. Could I get a little oil? Actually, it was not so bad in this car compared to what I'm used to. Today the phone I've been calling time after time after time. I put out the Toyota Corolla that had fixed up on the net for trying to selling it, and now the phone is calling like crazy, so it's a little difficult here. But next time I own this, I'm just going to change the filter here. I'm going to clean the muff and I'm going to change the filter inside, just to do those things. And now the ozone machine is just standing for 1 hour and just killing all kind of bacteria and viruses inside the car. So that is going to get okay. So, then I come back. Yeah, welcome back. Today I also have been a little around, so I've just come home and eaten something. I was hoping to just do some small things here, just to check. So I just have a short time and just do some servicing thing, because of course the air filter box is, it's the best air filter that I've seen in any car I have bought. This one is more or less completely like new. It's very, very little dirt on this one. That one is no point changing. One thing less. Yesterday when I come home, I was trying to find information about the timing belt, but I haven't found that, so I have to, one day I have to take off the cover on the top and check the belt to see how it is. And since I don't know when it's changed last time, I'm just going to order a new one. Anyway, I think, because I can't trust how long this has been in the car. So I just have to do that. I see I have some fluid down here, but I need more. And somewhere here I have red coolant standing. Just have to find that one and fill up a little. I think it stands in here now. Yeah. Yeah, I think it's the coolant. It's mixed up from a big bottle. Then I see. Still, I can put on more, so I have to see if I find my big can of coolant that need to be put in water in. And at least this now have coolant up to this line, so it's better than it was. Next thing I should have been doing is just check the sensor, airflow, air mass, air temperature. I hold down the locker. I found that it's easier this way. And then only two screws, if those screws are not filled up with dirt, they should be easy to get out. One is no problem. Yeah, this screw is coming too. Two screws. Put it in my box. Then you should be able to see this sensor. Actually, it's not as bad. The only thing I need to do, I use brake cleaning fluid. In here is the sensor for the air pressure, and up here should be the temperature sensor. It's a small sensor up here. I have more videos about this specific, but I just clean it with brake fluid, trying not to get it into the connection. Here, see. Yeah. Now I just have to go to the light and check it. Good thing with a brake fluid, brake cleaner, so it dry up fast. Now this should dry up before I think about starting up the car. Dry off dirt here, so I don't get any more inside. Just dry off some of this without touching the sensor. I dry it off outside. I have done this on many cars, so I'm not afraid to just put it back now. Two screws need to go back. This is a small cross, let's see, it's shaking on the video because the camera is standing on the same place as the rest. Putting the two screws back. And just putting the connector back. There. Then I've done that. One thing I was thinking about checking, since this fog light is missing, is there anything here that belongs to it? Looks like the connector is here. So only missing the lamp and fixing a damage here. We saw more small damage on the front, so it have been hit with something. Here is just paint starting to fall off. But I have ordered new fog lights in the front. I also ordered a new fog light for the back, because on one side in this little of the red plastic is supposed to be off. But maybe it's so little you more or less can't see it. I'm going to come back tomorrow night or the night after just to check the air filter inside. I haven't checked the quality of the oil, so maybe I have to change the oil. I have to check the automatic transmission oil if it's enough, if I need to clean out some. I have to polish up the lights. So coming, I have video about that. But that was outside in cold weather. So now I'm just going to do it inside. Maybe I can make a new video showing you guys that. Yeah, and if there's something you guys would say that I have to check up, do it now. Because it's very good if you put a comment. I'm also going to put on analytic OBD reader to read out if it's something that I can see there. So that's coming back with that too. So it's a lot of things. Maybe on some of the plastic in front and also some in the back. Maybe I have to do plastic welding. So maybe I test the equipment I got on this car instead of the Kia. So. Yeah. Then I can't do anything more today because I had to pick up the wife. But I'll come back with a little tomorrow, I hope, to see more of the car. As I have maybe tried to say before, I have a lot of videos about this car, how I tried to clean out the other GX 8-seated leather interior version that I also have still standing, because that one needs a lot more work. And I get that one for a very cheap price, of course. Price compared to quality is often very, very cheap cars need work. For me, that is not a point. That is not a problem, sorry. Because I like to try to find out a thing. I like to try to learn new things. And trying to make some videos for you guys at the same time. So please come back with ideas. Help me. Ask for things that I maybe help you. So it's important. This channel is all about helping out other guys. And trying to fix some of my project and learn something myself. So thank you. Please subscribe to the channel. And put a like if you like the video. Check out my other Land Cruiser videos, because it's many of them. I also have two other Land Cruisers and things standing, a 60 and a one more 120 Prado Land Cruiser. Yeah, thank you. Please come back. Goodbye.